one of the biggest professional sports in North America. In fact, it would be hard to argue that any other sport would be more popular than hockey. The NHL was founded in 1917 and has gone from a league where farmers would play hockey during the winter as a hobby to a multi-million dollar market where players can earn anywhere from $1 to $13 million a year. Hockey has always been and is still viewed as a tough, masculine sport. Men and hockey go hand in hand. For example, even when you look up hockey on Google, the pictures that mainly come up are all male. Nothing really shows anything about females playing hockey. Women have been participating in the recreation of hockey for over 100 years. The first women's teams were formed in 1910. Over the next century, there were efforts to start a professional women's hockey league, but nothing ever came from the efforts. Women would have to wait until 2004 to play semi-professional hockey in the WWHL, until 2006 for the CWHL. These leagues did not pay the players. In fact, women even lost money because of the cost of the training, equipment, and travel. The first fully professional women's hockey league only started in 2015. This demonstrates the vast difference in how men's and women's hockey has been viewed by society. In the last 100 years, men's hockey has grown to a vast international sport that pays millions of dollars, and the women only started to get paid in 2015. Anyone that knows hockey at all will know that there are two main differences between men and women's hockey. While players in the NHL wear visors on their helmets that only protect their eyes, the women must wear full cages. There is also a rule difference that men can body check and fight players on the other team, while body checking is a penalty and fighting is strictly not allowed at all in women's hockey. The reason for these differences goes back many years. It stems from the view that women are fragile and need more protection than men.
I think the biggest barrier I've had to overcome in my hockey career was just when I was younger, because I was from a smaller town. I had no choice but to play on a boys' team for hockey, just because there wasn't enough girls interested to make an all-girls team. So I found I was often picked on because I was a girl in like a male-dominated sport. So I was often told, like, girls can't play hockey, like, you're not good enough, like, go play ringette or go figure skate. So I found this was kind of tough to deal with, but I found a lot of my teammates were pretty supportive and stood up for me on and off the ice when it came to situations like this.
In this past year's NHL skills competition, there was a very important moment for women's hockey. The first ever woman competed against men in the fastest skater competition. Kendall Coyne Schofield led off the competition and recorded a time of 14.525 seconds. With this time, she placed 7th out of 8th in the competition. The fact that she was up against 8 of the fastest players in the NHL makes this position even more impressive. The reason this was such a big moment for women's hockey is that it showed with analytical proof that women can compete directly with men. Many of the NHL players gave huge praises to women that played hockey and the NWHL in general. Connor McDavid, who is known as the fastest skater in the world, said, "When she took off, I was like, wow. I thought she won that event. This single moment of 14.525 seconds instantly raised the respect that people had for female hockey players."
You know, we all grew up watching the NHL. We watch the guys in the NHL. It's the best league in the world. That's where all the best players play in the world. Why isn't that the same for the women?
You know, I am a professional hockey player, and I like to say that, but I don't necessarily live the life that people think. It's really visibility. People can't come and watch us and advocate for women's hockey if they don't know we exist, and that's getting us on mainstream networks. I would love for, like, my children or the next generation to just have a goal that I'm going to be a professional hockey player and knowing that that's going to be financially viable.
I think of where our sport can be, and I look at my teammates who do have to work those second jobs and think, okay, how do we change this for them, because this isn't going to cut it.
This means is that the NWHL players will make a lot less than the NHL players who play in the exact same sport. During the 2018-19 CWHL season, only 4 games were broadcasted compared to 300 NHL games that were broadcasted on Sportsnet alone. Canadian interest in women's hockey has also been increasing throughout the 20th century, and is just now starting to get an increase in the amount of broadcasting and interest for the media. Although the interest is growing in women's hockey, this difference in media representation can be attributed to the fact that women's hockey is still not as widespread as men's hockey. This is mainly due to the stereotypes that women have been portrayed by throughout the 1900s.
I think the main barrier when it comes to female hockey players in the media is just that I find that there's kind of a stigma around female hockey and that it's a lesser caliber in comparison to the male game. I think I've seen tons of positive changes in the world of female hockey, even over like the past 10 years. I think this has a lot to do with the trailblazers of women's hockey. So, you know, kind of the first one. In hockey, and even